Thank you, Mr. President. I too want to stand today to congratulate the House for their passage of the Violence Against Women Act, and I thank the Senator from New Hampshire for her kind remarks. I'm honored to have worked on this bill with Senator Leahy and my other colleagues here in the Senate. Senator Leahy and I have worked together for years on issues of domestic violence and stalking, and this is one of the key endeavors that we needed to get across the finish line, and now we see that we will, and we'll send this important legislation to the President. I'd also like to commend the advocates across the nation, and specifically the Idaho Coalition Against Sexual and Domestic Violence, who have worked tirelessly on this issue. As a longtime champion of the prevention of domestic violence, I'm glad to see that there are areas in Congress where we can come together to support these important causes. This act provides critical services to victims of violent crime, as well as to the agencies and organizations which provide important aid to those individuals. For nearly two decades, the Violence Against Women Act has been the centerpiece of our nation's commitment to ending domestic violence, dating violence, and sexual violence. This legislation provides access to legal and social services for survivors. It provides training to law enforcement and to prosecutors, to judges and attorneys and advocates to address these crimes in our nation's communities. It provides intervention for those who have witnessed abuse and are more likely to be involved in this type of violence. It provides shelter and resources for victims who have nowhere else to turn. There's significant evidence that these programs are working, not just in Idaho, but nationwide. The U.S. Department of Justice reported that the number of women killed by an intimate partner decreased by 35% between 1993 and 2008. In 2012, it was reported that in one day alone, 688 women and their children impacted by violence sought safety in an emergency shelter or received counseling, legal advocacy, or children's support. Mr. President, these important provisions are making a difference in the lives of people across this nation. And I, again, want to commend all of my colleagues who supported this legislation to help move this critical piece of legislation to the President's desk. Thank you very much.